In this session, we are discussing a very important algorithm, HipShot. Prior listening this particular video, you must be listening the video on hip insertion operation and hip deletion operation, where we discussed two algorithms, InSHIP and DelHip, because those two algorithms will be used in our HipShot algorithm. Okay, now see, this is our HipShot algorithm. So algo HipShot, A is the name of the array. So A is the name of the array, and this A is containing n number of data. They're not in the heap tree. We have taken input from the keyboard arbitrarily. User has given input from the keyboard, or we have read this n number of data from some data file or from some other sources. And this array has got populated with this n number of data in arbitrary order. No heap tree is there initially. So now I've come down to this. For I is equal to 1, I less than equal to n minus 1, I plus plus. So I is going to get increased from 1 to n minus 1. Let us suppose value of n is equal to 10. So this particular I will be ranging from 1 to 9. Okay. InSHIP. InSHIP algorithm, if you see, it is requiring 3 input arguments. A, the name of the array containing the heap tree. N, that means up to which location this heap tree is there, an item, that is the value to be inserted. And obviously in the InSHIP algorithm, we had our n is equal to n plus 1. So A is the name of the array, n is the number of nodes are there, number of values are there in the heap tree, up to which the heap tree got formed, and item is the new value going to be inserted there. So what will happen? The item will be inserted. It will get reheaped. So again, the heap tree will be having the proper shape. Obviously, here we are considering the max heap or min heap, whatever it is. And the value of n will be increased by 1. Why? Because obviously, after insertion, the number of value, the number of data should get increased. So now here, what is happening? I'm just writing A is the name of the array. So initially, I is equal to 1. So for first location, up to the first location, heap tree has been formed. You see, whenever there is one array containing only one data, obviously that is a heap tree, because there is no other data with which this particular data can be compared. So InSHIP, A is the name of the array, I is the respective location number up to which the heap tree has been formed. Initially I is equal to 1, and A2 is the data, that is the item going to be inserted there. Then what will happen? In the next iteration, I will become 2. So A is the name of the array. Up to the second location, heap tree has been formed. Yes, previously in the other prior iteration, we did that one. And then A3 is the item to be inserted. In the next iteration, A is the name of the array. Up to third location, heap tree has been formed. So A4 is the item to be inserted. In this way, I shall go on doing. So I shall get heap tree in the array A up to n location. What will be the last value for this? The last value is n minus 1. So at the last iteration, A is the heap tree formed up to n minus 1 location, and A n minus 1 plus 1. So nth data will be the item to be inserted. So ultimately, I'm getting full packed location number 1 to n in the array A in the form of heap tree. All the data will get arranged. Now coming to this while body, if n is greater than 1, then del heap A n item. So you know that in case of del heap, the value of n will be decreased by 1. You can watch the del heap algorithm in the earlier videos. So A is the name of the array. Up to n number of locations, heap tree was formed. And then after deletion, n will be decreased by 1. And the root node value will be going to the item. And then the reheaping will take place. So now what will happen? When I'm coming from this particular line to this line, the n has got decreased by 1. In our example, you consider that, let us suppose n is equal to 10. So after coming down to the next line, n has become 9. So the A array is containing heap tree nodes from the location number 1 to 9. So 9 plus 1, that is the 10th location I am putting this item. So I am deleting data from the 10 locations. So now it has got decreased by 1, and this location has got free, and the deleted node will be kept here. Then I'm dealing with from 1 to 9. Now after executing the del heap, it has become 1 to 8. And this free space, the item will be inserted. then 1 to 7 in the free space, the deleted item will be inserted. So now in this way, the things will take shape. So what will happen? In case of max heap, the maximum data will be placed at the last, at the nth place. Then the second maximum will be placed at the n minus 1th place. So in this way, if we proceed from 1 to n, you are getting smaller number to the larger number, smallest to the largest. So in which order you are getting? Smallest to the largest, which order? Obviously, it is nothing but in the ascending order. So you see, the deleted item which I am deleting at first is the maximum one, but that item is getting placed at the last location of the array, and the minimum value is found at the first location of the array. So in case of max heap, the heap shot will produce data in the ascending order. In case of min heap, the heap shot will produce data in the descending order. So the same thing is taking place. So now it will go on doing, and each and every time del heap is decreasing this value of n by 1. So ultimately, this n is greater than 1 will get false. So it will come out and return. That means the end of this particular algorithm. In this way, this heap shot is working. So we have discussed INSEEP, del heap, and this is our heap shot. So I think you are getting this logic. I have explained each and every line of this algorithm with the proper examples. Thanks for watching this particular video.